You know, that's trying to avoid God and saying, you know, you're saying you have to be perfect and this and that. Let me see. Cut the crap, cut the act. It's real simple. Where you stand is where you stand. If you stand as a family man, family woman, family, a family that's just together, when you're a family that's together, and, you know, chances of a family without God. If you don't have God in your life, then God is number one. It's real simple. I'm not going to keep explaining this to anybody. This goes to my family and anybody else's family out here. If you don't have God, then there's no way you're going to get with somebody that's converted to God, that has salvation, that has the cross of Jesus, and they, you know, believe in their finished works, and they already have their salvation. There's no way that it's going to work. And I don't care if you're trying to involve men, women, children, or whatever it is. Listen, say it once more and again. If you do not have God in your life, if that's not your desire, then whatever you want to work out, or however you want it to work out, no matter how many connections you try to make, it's all going to flop. Because you're not doing it for the right reasons. See, to want to be a family is a beautiful thing for anybody. But to want to be a family without God is not beautiful at all. That's a total abomination. And by in service, when you are service to God, we try to abominate our God, you're abominating us, you're abominating the family itself. So therefore, the chains that you're creating is a chain of confusion, and a chain of curses that you've probably already been in. And see, the curse, you want to pass the curse on because you don't know what to do with it. So you think by inviting more people and trying to make connections, I think you're creating a blessing. That's more of a curse that you're bringing. Once again, you're consulting people instead of God. So may you be accursed for doing that. But may you receive forgiveness from God for doing what you shouldn't be doing in life. You don't hook up with Pharaohs of life. You don't hook up with Rome. You don't hook up with the whoredoms of life. I don't care if your mother's a whore. You don't be a whore. You understand? If your father's a whore, you don't be a whore. Right? Because then you create a family of whores. And that goes to anybody. You understand? Everybody take it, and they take it offensively, and they think, you know, they take it personal. See, this is the thing. What I just said, that's the majority of the world anyway. That's a familiar spirit. So, right, so if you know me, and if you're doing that, and if you are second-rate in God, There's no story to it. There's no opinions, there's no facts, there's no nothing. If you don't have God in your life, which is going to show, and you have your child in your life, and you have your family in your life, you have this in your life, then you know what? If you have all that, and you don't have God, then that means that's your God. So, me personally, I'm going to live with my God, like I always do. I'm going to temple with my God. Now, some of y'all have your own temples. Well, love it. You understand? Love it. But don't invite me into any curses. You understand? Don't invite me to any curses or any omens or any ethers. Because you're renounced. Your dead loved ones that created that is renounced. Whoever you live with is renounced. Your child and everybody else is renounced. Because you're spreading the bad fruit that you have. Because you can't have good fruit if you're not born again. So there's no stories. There's no made up stuff. And like I said, may God bless your souls. But if you continue to abominate my God, may you be accursed. And that's scriptured. And as always, there's nothing but love, there's nothing but peace. But God creates the peace that you need. Not family, not friends, not babies, not husbands, not women, not a church. God in Christ, the head of the church, in Jesus' name, you'll be blessed. Amen.